Now, getting back to a subject that a lot of people don't seem to be familiar with concerning 9/11, that's World Trade Center 7, the third building to fall that day. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, most people, Chuck, don't even know about the third worst structural failure in modern history. In fact, most architects and engineers know nothing about it. Why? It wasn't played for us on the media. All we see is the planes hitting these towers and the towers burning ferociously and then exploding before our eyes in this incredible volcanic eruption is what it really looks like, and we'll get to that in a moment. But this third building is a 47-story skyscraper, which on the afternoon of 9/11 begins a precipitous, sudden, and symmetrical descent straight down into its own footprint.
All right, welcome back, everyone. You are here on Gnosis because it's between 3 and 4 p.m. on a Saturday on AM 1330 KJLL. So I must be bringing you all the news that the news isn't talking about. And today I am going to be bringing you a repeat guest here on Gnosis who is going to be giving a presentation tonight down at St. Mark's Church starting at 7 p.m. And that is on 3rd Street, I believe. Let me find the... 3809 East 3rd Street near Speedway and Alvernon. A $7 suggested donation strongly suggested and definitely appreciated. And that will be your ticket in to hear Richard Gage to give his full presentation. Richard Gage, AIA, the American Institute of Architects. He is also the founder of Architects and Engineers for 9/11 Truth. Now, if you look at events of 9/11, certainly there's questions that surround that day. Maybe not for some folks, but for those who might dabble in logic or physics or things of that nature, you might, reasonably ask questions like, how is it that three buildings collapsed entirely in their own footprint, ostensibly due to structural fires, something that had never happened before or since, I might add, in the history of high-rise structural fires, including World Trade Center 7, one that did not sustain significant damage from debris from the two main towers falling earlier that day. It certainly wasn't struck by a plane. And in 2008, the government went so far as to claim that one of the causes was burning office papers that somehow magically melted all of the girders there in World Trade Center 7 and instantaneously caused them to give way all at the same time. I mean, asymmetrical damage causing symmetrical collapse? I'm not sure. In any event, we have our guest today to talk about that, and that is Richard Gage, AIA. Thank you so much for taking time out of your schedule and coming right from the airport to come down to the show, sir.
You're so welcome, Chuck. It's great to be here in Tucson.
And anybody who wants to join the conversation today, all you got to do is get your digits walking on your telephone at 529-3508, area code 520 if you're listening online at www.tucsonsjolt.com on our Listen Live link, if you might be out of our broadcast signal. Hopefully you're not, but if you are, you are tuned in here because this is Gnosis, and we are talking about exactly what happened that day. Now, a lot of people say, well, who do you think did it or what happened? 9/11 has cropped up quite a bit in the last few shows. And so this dovetails nicely with kind of the way the bent of the conversation. But that isn't the question that Architects and Engineers for 9/11 Truth is looking to answer, is who did it, so much as just say, well, wait, how did it happen in the way you allege if A, B, and C are true? Well, let's go through A, B, and C and, some of your contentions as to why the official story doesn't hold water.
You bet. Well, I've been an architect for 20 years, and I was on my way to a construction meeting, and I heard some of this evidence on the radio, and I blew me away. I've been going, what? How could this possibly be true? I went, I checked it out. My God, it turned out to be verifiable. This is scientific evidence that we have not been given by the mainstream media, by the government, and yet it's all there, all these witnesses. All of this is on video, too. It's just not, it's been hidden. For instance, we have several tons of molten metal found underneath the debris piles of World Trade Center 7 that you mentioned, and also the Twin Towers. Now, this molten metal turns out to be molten iron. Okay, it's not even melted steel. And even if it were, you can't melt steel with normal office fires or with jet fuel. These incredible quantities, they said, flowing like lava, the first responders. It turns out that all of this molten metal has been tested. It has the evidence of thermite in it. Thermite is an incendiary used by the military to cut through steel like a hot knife through butter. So what is this evidence doing in the molten metal? It's also in this the dust that was rampant throughout the World Trade Center tower.
Yes, well, getting to the thermite, some people have asked me if that couldn't be, the byproduct of burning, chemicals or something that was in the building that, you know, would cause some sort of false positive. Is that a possibility?
No. In fact, what they find, this group of scientists in the dust, is these small chips of nanocomposite explosives. They're 16th of an inch large. They are in all of the World Trade Center dust samples that they've tested, and contain particles that are so small. They're small as a human, 1,000 times smaller than a human hair, at the nanoscale of iron and aluminum, the composite elements of thermite. So this is extremely high tech stuff.
Now, why is the extreme smallness of these particles important?
Well, when you reduce the size of the iron and aluminum, the surface area becomes incredible. So therefore, it's an incendiary now becomes explosive. It can be engineered for any degree of explosiveness that one might need. The question is, why is it in all the dust samples? Why is and when they put these chips in a heater, basically, a differential scanning calorimeter, at 420 degrees centigrade, which is about 800 or 1,000 degrees, it blows up. So it's very clearly not paint chips.
Well, it's very clear that Osama and his 19 cohorts somehow managed to force their way into the World Trade Towers in the 2 or 3 months leading up to the event, and somehow paint this on every girder at every level. Either that or somebody else. Perhaps we should be inquiring of the Securicom, the company that was headed by George Bush's cousin, Wirt Walker, and was letting people in. There's lots of reports. People ask, well, how were explosives put in if this wasn't caused by jet fuel? There are numerous reports from people who worked in the building of shutdowns, for security or maintenance purposes in the 6 or so months leading up to 9/11. How much thermite or nanothermite would it take, in your estimation, to cause the effects that we see?
Well, how much did they find in the dust? They found about 10 tons by extrapolating the weight of what they found in each sample. They find about 10 tons of these iron-rich microspheres as well. So these spheres are about the size of a diameter of a human hair. And the official sources, USGS, R.J. Lee, they find so many of these iron spheres in the dust that they say it's not even World Trade Center dust unless the iron spheres are there.
Wow, it's a marker, in other words. Well, folks, we are going to have to step aside for some mainstream CNN news and let them tell you what they're going to tell you. But stay here on the dial or on the computer. We will be back with more Richard Gage from Architects and Engineers for 9/11 Truth right after this.
So I usually start out with the buildings, and I don't know how I got into that. Something he said got me off. So
AM 1330, KJLL.
We'll get right into Building 7.
CNN Radio.
I'm April Williams.
Let me be the expert on the buildings.
Okay, sorry.
You started telling him about Building 7. You kind of stole my thunder on the buildings.
I apologize. Excuse me.
That's okay.
Sorry. Look, where do you want to start when we come back?
Just ask me questions and I'll answer them.
Sure. What do you want to
tell us more about this Building 7, and then I'll